Hello and welcome back to FLIR PRIMED. I'm Grant Coffey. White powders. They can be just about anything. They can be from bio powders like the recent anthrax scares to narcotics, explosives, toxins, or something as mundane as flour, chalk, or baby powder. We're going to examine every one of these categories in future episodes. But for now, let's look at a category that's been very common in recent years, and that's narcotic powders. Identification in this era of terrorism is extremely important. After we rule out the presence of radiation or the absence of such, and we rule out any other issues with toxins, we can focus on the powder itself. Is it chalk on a football field? Is it baby powder in a powdering room? Is it powdered donuts in a cafeteria? We've actually had all of those calls. But what I'm really worried about is of concern is this a place where they're manufacturing these powders? Is it a Klan lab scene? It's extremely important, very dangerous scene, and one that we have to take special precautions on. Let's talk about those scenes now. First of all, if you discover a place where you think these powders are being manufactured, that is there lab gear there? Is there a bunch of precursor chemical materials? We have a download on this where you'll be able to identify some of those at the end of the episode. If those are all present at one time, and we determine it's a lab, let's talk about specific steps that you can take to be safe on that scene. Number one, you want to establish zones immediately. You want to pull back, and we'll talk about this later, but you want to do what we call the cavalry. If we've ruled out all the other safety issues, it's not a working lab. If it's just a refined product, we want to use disciplined SOPs working with our law partners, because remember, this is a crime scene. So first of all, while we're taking these samples and assisting, we want to observe PPE precautions. And at a minimum, that means Tyvek or bunker gear, a layer. In addition, goggles, mask or filter mask protection, and gloves, preferably double gloves if we can. We want to take samples. We'll talk about that in a later episode. But taking samples and bagging them, double bagging them, making sure that there's no contamination on the outside, labeling them, and overpack our sample. Label the sample, observe chain of custody issues, and one thing not to forget, you don't want to trample on the evidence on a scene like this. We've got a great download for this episode too. You can check it out at FLIR.com/prime. Thank you for watching.